talent we had.
So this is the first in a series of videos tracking the progress of my ayahuasca graphic novel. A graphic novel is an attempted grown-up term to refer to a comic book. However, I think this is one of the best methods we have of faithfully portraying the ayahuasca experience. The in-depth monologue of the written word and the visual portrayal of the inner worlds that the ayahuasca produces through art, all in a sequential scene-by-scene narrative. So this video series will follow the creation of that, as I travel across Peru and America encountering people and further ayahuasca experiences that will influence and inspire the graphic novel. So I hope you'll enjoy watching the creation of it. Still very much in its infancy, I'm still in the stages of writing and storyboarding the project. The goal right now is to get enough groundwork sorted so I can work on it sufficiently while on the road. One of the important elements during this groundwork stage is to go over all the field notes that I made during the time of my ayahuasca experiences. I made a whole bunch of notes and thumbnail sketches, just about enough to be able to reignite my memory at a later date so that I could go back to them and expand upon them. And that's really what I'm doing right now, going over all the original notes and fleshing them out, storyboarding various elements of the story, trying to make some sort of cohesive narrative out of the whole story, whilst keeping as faithful to the original ayahuasca experience as possible, both visually and narratively. So these are what we call thumbnail sketches, and this is usually how I would begin to try and visualize my ayahuasca experiences, how this would be shown in a narrative, any kind of narrative structure. And at this point, we're not looking for, you know, amazing drawings, we're just looking for something that can be produced really quickly and really efficiently, because I did this a lot when I used to work in the animation industry, and as we were storyboarding, trying to figure out this story, how to visualize the story, we'd have to produce many hundreds of these little panel drawings, because often we'd, you know, draw some scenes, bits of the scene wouldn't work out, so we'd have to sort of scrap a lot of these and then redo them again and again. So if you're in this stage drawing anything, drawing any kind of really well-drawn images, it's just going to take a little too much time, and often you'll be ended up wasting a lot of your time if you end up doing that. So you just need to do some really quick drawings to try and just get the story down onto paper. So this is usually how I'd begin, and I'd often, you know, take a lot of these panels, some choice scenes that I want to see mocked up in more detail. I'd take some of these, put them into the computer, color them up, see how they look with color, because the ayahuasca experiences are very detailed, lots of intricate detail, and that usually can't be brought out through these little sketches. And so I'd often need to take these images further and expand upon them. So this is that in this stage. This is the first initial stage. And now I'll take a look at some of these storyboards that I've already done already and how I've mocked them up from this stage and then onto the computer. So let's take a look at that. Okay, so we are now inside my computer. And here we are in Photoshop, which is primarily the main program I use when painting up some of these storyboard panels on the computer. And so this is actually, this is one of the very first ayahuasca experience I had. And this one was very visual. There was not a lot of dialogue throughout this. Often with these ayahuasca experiences, you initiate a kind of dialogue between you and so-called spirits within the ayahuasca. But this was just me, this is a very lighter dose of ayahuasca to sort of get used to it. And it's just me sitting back and enjoying these visuals. And now I do remember, it really was this bright, these images, because I remember lying down in the ceremony and it almost hurt my eyes, it was that bright. It was really quite, you know, I had no idea the images seen behind closed eyes within ayahuasca experience would be this vivid and this clear, this amount of clarity to the image. It was really, I mean, these storyboards still quite, childlike compared to the kind of intricate detail you see within an ayahuasca experience. So these are still quite simple compared to the type of complexity I aim to be painting in the full final images of the ayahuasca graphic novel. So here, here in all these kind of geometric patterns, and these were all moving in kind of opposing directions, and just the whole scene was all really very animated. Then it switched to this one here with, and it was all these geometric straight edges were all sort of converging, moving all into the middle here, and this generated great light in the middle of this image. And as we went further on in this vision, the vision panned back, and we saw that these shapes were actually all on the side of this pyramid structure, and this glowing white spot in the middle was actually the tip of the pyramid. And as I pulled back to see the entire pyramid, a great beam of light shot off from the tip of the pyramid into the heavens above. And now this isn't every scene from this first ayahuasca experience. I think, as I mentioned before, I sort of detail out the entire experience just in rough thumbnail, and then I'll take a few choice panels from those thumbnails and paint them up on the computer to get a good vibe of how the ayahuasca experience went. Just selecting those that most define that particular ceremony. And then this one here is a very kind of organic shape within this vision, and it had a very much a life of its own, and it sort of fluctuated almost like a squid or octopus legs, and it really had a life of its own. Again, hugely bright glowing colours that almost hurt my eyes. So let's move on to some more storyboards here. I think this is moving on to almost, this is within my second or third ceremony, and yeah, this was being confronted with lots of different flowers which were opening up and just sort of expanding right in front of my vision. And here you go, this is how it started off here, and there's a sort of great glow within as they, these flower petals unfolded. There was golden writing around the edges of these flowers that looked like some kind of scripture, some kind of language. Nothing I was familiar with. It looked very alien, and I was trying to decipher what exactly it looked like. This is my attempted visualization of it, almost a bit like Japanese script in a sense, but with many more curves to it. And as I try to read this, I just become overwhelmed by all these symbols, and the symbols just infiltrate my entire vision. And then this is later on. This is actually, this appears in my Tierra Vida ayahuasca documentary. These were some of the earliest spirits I encountered. And yeah, they opened up a dialogue where they were saying things like, "Now, Alex, you really haven't been paying attention to us. We've been calling to you for quite a long time, and you just haven't been listening to us. It's time you opened up your ears and listen to what we have to tell you." And of course, at the time I didn't know, I was very frustrated, and like, I don't know how to initiate this dialogue with you. So later on in this ceremony, I remember behind closed eyes, within my mind's eye, I could visualize just a stream of all these individual little spirits that seemed like very young spirits. And one of them pulled themselves out of this stream and came right into my field of vision. And as I moved on from this to try and visualize different visions, the same spirit kept infiltrating my vision. So here you have a series of all of these sort of glowing green orbs amongst a blue background. But as I see this, the spirit comes into and manipulates the vision herself. As we see here, it embraces the vision I had and The whole vision is engulfed in white light. And then it becomes very much apparent that suddenly this spirit is within me. And I hear clear as day, just as clear as I'm speaking to you now, just a sudden excited, "Hello." It was saying how at that very moment it was within me and how it saw everything about myself. It saw all my memories. And as it did that, suddenly said, "But I must be off now." And suddenly, because this was a very, almost extraordinary experience for myself, I can almost believe it was happening. I was sort of called out, "Don't go, stay, maybe we can open up a dialogue." And this seemed too excited. It had a very kind of young energy to it, which made me think this was perhaps a very young spirit. And so it dashed right back into my being. And it fluctuated. It was always fluctuating into many different forms. But as I said this, it sort of formed into this great kind of beautiful bird of paradise entity. And so those are just a few of these storyboards that I've taken from this thumbnail process, put it into the computer to try and expand upon that, and as I can do better with color and more time, better get across the vibe and the emotions felt within that particular ayahuasca ceremony. So as I said before, this is still very simple. The images are still very simple in terms of how the ayahuasca experiences actually are. They're just vastly, vastly more complex and all this intricate detail than I'm bringing across even in these storyboards. So that'll be something I'm going to have to attempt to bring across in these final pages of the ayahuasca graphic novel. So I'll leave that there just for now, just to introduce some of these color storyboards. And now I think what I'll do is I'll show you the process I go through of just creating a set of these thumbnail sketches, and that will take the entire time of the rest of this episode. And then on the next episode, I'll record the whole process of me creating one of these colored storyboards. So I'll take some of the thumbnails I produce later on, next episode, put them into the computer, and you can see how I transform these simple thumbnail sketches into somewhat more simple color storyboards. So let's take a look at that. So right now I am thumbnailing parts of the script right now, and I'll show you my process of going through that. I'll print out the script and read through it, sort of try and start visualizing in my head how this will look. Because it's a good idea to have a clear picture in your head before you go ahead and start thumbnailing. So with this process of thumbnailing, we're not looking for really spectacular drawings. We're just trying to get anything down, just something really quick, just to get the visual story down. And then we'd go back later on and we would flesh out a lot of these drawings and expand upon them. So this particular experience was when I took ayahuasca in a deep nature environment. I was sitting around a campfire with a friend of mine, and I remember the effects of the ayahuasca beginning to take effect by a kind of, just the apparition of this sort of little snake that kind of crept through the campfire into my mouth, which initiated the visions of the ayahuasca that followed. So with the story set in mind, I'll begin sort of thumbnailing this idea out. So if I begin, me sat in front of this campfire. So as I said, just looking for really quick, rough sketches, just something to lay down the initial composition. Trying to get the story to flow in a visual narrative style. So this is my very crude picture of me in front of a campfire. This is just me silhouetted here. Now, what is a good technique to note at this point is to use the rule of composition, which is the golden ratio. And this is a pattern that is used throughout nature. And it goes something a little like this. I think you'll recognize it as soon as I draw it. And what this is setting up a composition that is very pleasing to the eye, and it's very easy to view such a composition. So this is the dividing line down here. And what happens is if you place your focal content, what you want the viewer to look at, in this general area, then it'll be a very pleasing composition for the viewer to look at. You know, they use this a lot in cinema and talks if someone's speaking to the camera. Sorry, I get a close-up of this one here. So often there'll be a character talking to the camera and following this rule of thirds, this golden ratio concept. There'll be someone talking to the camera, usually in this kind of composition. My crude drawing of a figure here. And actually, if you study a lot of films, you see people using this technique quite a lot. You know, there's a scene, I think it's in the second Matrix film, when Agent Smith and Neo finally have a confrontation, and the camera darts back and forth between these two, talking to each other, and one of the characters is on this side, and one of them is on this side. It keeps cutting back between the two. So anyway, back to this storyboarding. So this is me establishing the scene of me watching this campfire, waiting for the effects of the ayahuasca to take hold. And so, if I've established that shot, then you know, I want to sort of begin drawing how the snake came through the campfire. So if I set, often a good technique is to angle the camera slightly to give a bit of a more dynamic feel to it. So if I now draw closer up at this campfire, these are just the rocks around this campfire. And what this did, this image of this snake, is it kind of split between the middle of this campfire. It was pulsating colors of green and yellow and a lot of colors that you would be familiar with if you had an ayahuasca experience. So this would also be giving off a lot of light, and just in the background it would all be caught in shadow. So I just imagine the path this snake took. Came through the campfire and slithered upwards towards me. So again, just reiterating, if you can't already notice, I'm not looking for fantastic drawings, just looking for anything to put down onto paper. And actually, I've just realized as I've gone along with this process, it would be a good idea to, before these shots, say this is shot one, I want to change this into shot three, this will be four. I want one shot before this where I focus on this apparition, this image of this snake weeding its way through these flames. And so with this shot, I can establish early on the design patterns of how this snake looked. And I do have a clear picture of how this looked in my head, but for the sake of just getting down a composition, which is how the shot looks, something's quick as that will do. So this will be shot number two. I'll put this back here. So it'll be me in front of the campfire. This is my back in silhouette, focus on a closer up view of the campfire with this snake sort of making its way through the middle of this campfire. But before that, I want to establish a close up of this snake image and how it looked. And so now I'll change up the scenes a bit. Let me just separate this to make sure I don't get it confused. now I want to switch up the angles a bit, and if I try and make a shot from the perspective of this snake. So, let me figure out my perspective lines. This is the, if you're not familiar with perspective, these are vanishing points where our eye is led towards. And often, with these perspective lines, you want to lead the viewer's eye to a certain image you're trying to bring their attention to. So, in this instance, it's me sitting down watching this campfire. And that's what our eye will be led towards. However, in the foreground, I want to establish the perspective of this snake. So if I just put a corner of the campfire here, that's going to be where I paint up these flames of the campfire. And if I just draw the snake coming from this campfire, heading in the general direction of where I'm sitting. So your eye, the viewer's eye, will start from the left, where the snake and campfire is, and follow the line of perspective towards me. And we can do various certain little tricks and pieces where there are elements of the background which kind of all have lines somehow pointing to what I want to lead the viewer to. If you go back and study a lot of old paintings, you'll discover, let me just do a very crude drawing quickly. You know, they have a lot of these Michelangelo paintings, often of Jesus Christ and things. And so you have Jesus in one section of the painting. This is my Jesus Christ image. And as a side note, often this figure will be a lot brighter and more saturated than everyone else around. But if you just look at all the people around Jesus, they'll all have lines somehow pointing to him. Some people are actually pointing to him. Another person will be holding some sort of item, but it's angled in such a way that it points towards our focus point, in this case, this image of Jesus. So there are all these little compositional tricks to lead the viewer into to what we want them to look at. So anyway, back to these storyboards. So at this point I've established this snake and campfire, but I think at this point now, it's been quite a while. Let me just write, this is shot number 5. Here we go, shot number 6. You want to establish my reaction to this, I think. So if we focus on close-up shot of my face, again, if we follow the golden ratio example, so that I am placed within this ratio. No, I want something larger than that. A head this size. Something that size. Eye level, nose, mouth, blah, blah, blah. So this is where I will be. Everything else will be in darkness because the only light has come from this campfire, so there'll be sort of heavy shading on my form from this. So I'll go back and establish the kind of emotion I want to convey in this reaction of mine. And I think now we want to do the reaction where this snake is coming towards me. So let me angle this better. And is coming into my mouth. This is a very bizarre circumstance I found myself in. So if you go for a kind of almost side angle view, so the middle of my face is down this line here, that's the eye level, so not quite complete profile but close enough. So it's the composition of where I want my head to be, and I think I may end up doing a closer shot than this. This is a little far away. And so the snake will be snaking in from this side of the shot. So that's to establish me and the snake now in the shot together. And I think I can jump right ahead to a close-up of the snake working its way into my mouth, which is a very strange thing to say, but that's what happened. So this is my... It's going to be an extreme close-up of my mouth. So, something... An angle similar to this, and often at these points, just like the drawings are going to be very, very rough, the angles are still quite rough, and often I'll go back and revisit all of these frames, trying to push the dynamic angles, trying to get something a little more exciting out of it. And now this is where it becomes a little difficult, because obviously I had this experience, but it was very, I felt it. I didn't exactly visually see this snake going into my system, but I think because we are using the visual medium, I will bend the rules of the ayahuasca experience just a little bit in order to show what I felt. So it's my face again, and I guess visually show almost like an x-ray of this snake, which had a great light to it. It generated great amounts of light. So I can, I guess, visualize that by having a great light slither down me. And now I want to cut further out to a more distant shot. I guess my chin is here. You want to be getting the torso in. So if my hand is now over my chest as I experience this vision of a snake coming down into my system. And as it reached the pit of my stomach, it twirled round and settled in there. I think it was almost a visual metaphor of this ayahuasca setting in the pit of my stomach, and from that the effects of the ayahuasca took effect. I think I'll have a close-up of this snake settling down, twirling around in my stomach. And I remember, behind closed eyes, I could visualize all of this happening. And it created kind of many sacred shapes around this instance. And again, I can see this within my mind, but for now, I just want to get down the basic composition. Running out of space here. And I think now would be a good time to show my reaction to this as well. And I remember the feelings clearly. So if we focus on an even closer up shot of my reaction to this than we've had before. Eyes closed, contemplating, seeing within my mind's eye this stuff happening. Because when you have an ayahuasca experience, you don't have these visions with eyes open. We have these visions behind closed eyes. So this is me, downcast face. Seeing what is happening to myself. Of course, surrounded by the darkness of nature, so this will be all in black. And that will put a lot of emphasis on my face. And And so this instance of this snake appearing out of the campfire, making its way towards me, into my mouth, into my system, is what initiated all the visions that followed. And I remember it was almost as if someone had just flicked a switch and suddenly I was in this altered state. Now, this shot is going to be the same instance, though from a different angle, and it will continue on the motion. So me, downcast faced, rather crudely, but, and we'll have the light of the campfire catching aspects of the background, so we'll see the highlights and contours of the trees and plant life around me. And this will be good to show the contrast between the flick of the switch, where in one instance I am in my normal surroundings, and when this snake reaches the pit of my stomach, the visions initiate and I am somehow finding myself in this altered state. And I remember breathing almost a great sigh of release as tension is released and I am somehow here. So bringing my head up, and almost in the instant I exhale, my world has completely changed, and all around me are visions of organic plant life that has a life of its own, fluctuating in many beautiful colors, greens, yellows, and blues. And though I can't convey this, these visions with just these quick pen thumbnail sketches, as I take these thumbnails to paint them up in more detail on the computer, this will be something that works its way into the painting. And so that would be me starting the ayahuasca experience. So let us go over from the beginning again. So we started on panel one here. This is my back in silhouette, watching this campfire. I'm in this instance of the screen, and here is it. So here will be very light, all lit by the campfire. And this will be me in silhouette, so it'll be a nice contrast between the two. And then we have this scene here, scene shot number two, where in my mind's eye, I visualize this beautiful, colorful, fluctuate in many different colors, snake, very sort of transparent, making its way through this campfire. And this will be my close-up shot where I, as accurately as possible, try to visualize how I saw this in the ayahuasca vision. And then moving up to shot three up here, we cut back further, so the whole campfire is in shot, closer than this one, but further out from this. And we see the path of this snake as it makes its way through the campfire upwards, cut into a shot from the snake's perspective here, where we see the snake and we see the direction it's going in, which is myself sitting down here. And now we have a kind of bust torso shot of myself sort of reacting to this. Then, this one here, number 7, 8, 9, so on. As we cut to an almost profile view where the snake has made its way here and it's continued its journey into this shot here, where it is meeting with myself And then we cut to this extreme close-up of my mouth as this snake goes into my system. Cutting out further out to show the snake going, making its way all the way down to the pit of my stomach, where it initiates the visions that follow. And then we have a very close close-up of me reacting to this, continuing the action into a different shot. As I exhale, all the visions follow. And so that was the very introduction to one of the ayahuasca ceremonies I had. Now what I'll do is I'm going to speed ahead and work on a few more thumbnails and then show them after this, just so that this video doesn't get to be too long. Okay, so here I've sped on ahead to produce some more storyboards, outlining more of this particular ayahuasca experience. There's a whole range of different panels ranging from trying to visualize the actual ayahuasca visuals and also some of my reactions to this and talking to my friend next to me at the campfire, sharing our particular ayahuasca experiences. And so even at this stage, I'm noticing a few panels that I want to take further and paint up on the computer in more detail to, I guess, embody that particular ceremony. So this is how I begin visualizing the ayahuasca experience. These are just the simple thumbnails. And from this stage, I'll take a few of these and, yeah, paint them up on the computer. So that is the thumbnail process. I keep running to the top.